Welcome to the Crypto Mastery Class. I'm Susie, aka Crypto Girl, and we've got Joe on the line, the creator of the Crypto Mastery Indicators. So we are here today to make crypto easy to understand and simple to invest in. We're going to look at the news, some overall market charts, hot movers in the basket, and just overall in the market and indicators, and most importantly, question and answers. Let's jump in. So USDT, which is known as Tether, market cap is up by $2 billion following the tornado cash debacle by Gareth on Cointelegram.com. So Tether's market capitalization has reversed a three-month downtrend, while USDC sees a drop in value after the US imposed sanctions against Tornado Cash. The market capitalization of Tether, USDT, tokens has increased by nearly $2 billion since the US Treasury Department imposed sanctions on cryptocurrency Mixer Tornado Cash. The Office of Foreign Asset Control essentially barred Americans from using Tornado Cash on August 8th, blacklisting 44 USDC coins, USDC, and Ether, ETH addresses connected to the service to a list of specially designated nationals and blocked persons, known as SDN. OFAC alleges that Tornado Cash was used by individuals and criminal organizations to launder over $7 billion worth of cryptocurrency since 2019. Funds linked to North Korea Lazarus Group hackers are also believed to have been mixed through Tornado Cash. Circle, the issuer of the stablecoin USDC, went as far as freezing assets linked to the 44 addresses flagged by OFAC. The move by Circle was warranted given the potential ramifications for continuing to interact with the addresses. Penalties for non-compliance ranges from fees of $50,000 to $10 million and 10 to 30 years of imprisonment. Circle froze 75,000 USDC worth of funds linked to the accounts in question in an effort to be fully compliant with Treasury ruling. Interestingly, the market cap of USDC has declined by some $2 billion from highs of around $55 billion over the past month to its current capitalization around $53 billion. The USDC decline has been noted by various cryptocurrency market participants on social media, with a correlation being drawn between the decline of the USDC market and the increase in the capitalization of USDT, which is Tether. Now we have Ripple executive joins Algorand Foundation, and that's on U.today. Devin Murthy, former senior manager of business development, APAC, at Ripple, has moved to join the Algorand Foundation. The announcement by the Algorand Foundation CEO reads, "Wow, I'm excited to announce that Devin Murthy has just joined the Algo Foundation as head of ecosystem access. He will wake up every morning worried about whether the Algo and ASAs are listed on exchanges and in wallets, etc. He comes from Ripple." I'm sorry, Ripple. As reported by U.today, a former Cardano technical contributor, John Allen Woods, has also moved to join the Algorand Foundation as its CTO. Cardano creator Charles Hoskinson praised the Algorand community, saying, "Algorand is an excellent project with the exceptional people." While responding to the news of Allen Woods' move in late July, former Algorand CEO Stephen Kakinos announced his resignation to pursue other interests, but he would remain as a senior advisor until mid-2023. Algorand thus promoted Chief Operating Officer W. Sean Ford to the interim CEO afterward. Ford, who joined Algorand in 2018, had overseen go-to-market execution and operations. And last on the news, we have Ethereum price analysis. Ethereum slowly trades sideways at $1,900 after another surge lower coming by Lapin on Cryptopolitan.com. Ethereum price analysis is bearish today as we have seen a retrace to 1,900 and not a lot of reaction higher as consolidation was formed around 1,900. Therefore, we expect Ethereum USD to retrace even lower and look to push towards the 1,800 next support. The market has traded in the red over the last 24 hours. The leader Bitcoin declined by 1.39%, while Ethereum by 1.94%. Ethereum USD traded in a range of 1,862 to 1,926, indicating substantial volatility over the last 24 hours. Trading volume has declined by 21.47%, totaling $16.24 billion, while the total market cap trades around $229 billion, resulting in a market dominance of 20.09%. On the 4-hour chart, we can see consolidation formed as recovery did not follow overnight, indicating that further retrace can be expected over the next days. Ethereum price action has seen a strong new swing high set over the past days. After several days of strong bullish momentum from the 1,680 support, a gain of over 20% was reached on Sunday. Go Ethereum! From there, Ethereum USD retraced to 1,900 before quickly spiking to set a lower local high below 2,000. Later, another attempt to retrace followed below the 1,900 mark, indicating that selling pressure is still strong. However, for now, the Ethereum price has failed to break lower as consolidation began early yesterday. Since then, Ethereum USD has failed to move higher several times, indicating that another drop lower will follow to the 1,800 next major support. Ethereum price analysis is bearish today as we have seen consolidation over the last 24 hours as bulls failed to take over a strong decline early yesterday. Ethereum USD will likely continue moving sideways over the next hours before enough momentum is gathered to break towards the 1,800 support. So now we're going to look at the overall market and then we'll go into Bitcoin and Ethereum. So on coinmarketcap.com, you can find the total cryptocurrency market cap. We're at $1.1 trillion right now. And you can see how much we've moved in the last 7 days. So this is the 7-day chart. And I've got the line on the 1.15 trillion mark. You can see that we had some big dips. Looks like it could have been yesterday where it went down as far as 1.05 trillion. And then there was an immediate buyback. All right, now this is the 1 week performance in market cap block size. So what you see here is each block represents the dominance of this particular asset within the entire spectrum of crypto. So we have Bitcoin as a dominance at 38.82%. Now, I want to note, guys, that's typically been around 40%. So Bitcoin is losing its dominance, which means that of all the money invested in crypto, 38% of it is in Bitcoin. So therefore, it is people, if we dropped almost like a 1.2% dominance, that means that money is going somewhere else. So it'll be exciting to look at the market today and see where or what market cap has gone up to say, well, where did the money go? So you can always look at this and you can see the block size. So we have Ethereum, and maybe it went from Bitcoin to Ethereum. It's up 5.82%. And the color coding on this, if you're new here today, is the light red means the price went down one step. And so Bitcoin is highlighted a light red. And then Ethereum is a medium green, and that means the price went up two steps. And then if you look down below Ethereum, you see ADA, that's Cardano. Light green means the price went up one step. And Cardano went up 3.66% in the last week. And then if you put your eyes in the upper right-hand section, you can see the dark green means the price went up three steps, and it looks like SHIB went up 28%. So coin360.com is a great place to look at some heat maps, and you can also pull a drop down and see in different time frames too. So we're going to look at the cryptomastery.online indicators now. So If you want to subscribe, you can click on or go to cryptomastery.online, and there's going to be some in-depth tutorials about how to use these indicators. It's very worthwhile. So we'd love to have you guys join our team. So this is the Bitcoin USD 1 week performance charts with the Crypto Mastery indicators. So the top indicator, we have the average true range, and that currently for Bitcoin is still bearish. And then you have the early reversal that comes in, and we are still waiting for the early reversal, the most recent early reversal to come in. So I put a little eyeball next to that saying we're waiting on that, and we're waiting on the average true range to go from bearish to bullish, meaning red to green. But below those indicators, you have the trend indicator. Now, the trend indicator for Bitcoin, the key came in last week, and this week you had the bell came in. And the bell means it's time to really consider, you know, you may want to jump in on this one or a percentage or something. I'm not a financial advisor, so it's not financial advice, but there's just indicators when collaboratively reviewed and understanding what's going on in the direction, the momentum, they're helpful to make good conscious choices while you're managing your own portfolio. So below the trend indicator, you see the trend strength, and those are the green arrows moving up. So 1, 2, 3, 4, there's 5 arrows. So the last 5 weeks, Bitcoin has been moving upward. So I put a check mark next to the ones where all signs are showing upward movement. Then below the trend strength, you have the signal line, and that is turned from red to green. Now, they're still tight. The gold line and the green line are still tight. So therefore, that means it's not as a strong momentum upward as it could be when they're very close. So as reflected in the top indicators with the average true range and the early reversal. So once those click as upward movement, then all stars are aligned, but not yet. It's still a waiting period for 100% confidence. Then you have the volatility index. I put a check mark there because I love the volatility index indicator. This is when you can see when this particular asset is oversold. And from 0 to 20, the bottom thin red line is 0. The thick red line is a 20 line. And you could look on the right-hand side and you can see that Bitcoin is currently at 12.06 volatility index. So that means, in a sense, you're buying it on a very good low floor. Once it gets up out of that 20 area, you get into what we call let the cake bake zone, meaning it's already in movement. And when you get to the top area of that volatility index, that's 80 to 100. And that's typically a good ceiling or take profit time. Depending on your risk levels and your tolerance. All right, so next we're going to look at, here's the Ethereum USD 1 week performance chart with the Crypto Master indicators. Just like Bitcoin, the average true range is still showing red, bearish, meaning that it's not flipped the switch to say, yes, we are in an absolute upward momentum yet. And the early reversal, we're waiting for that to come in too. Then you have the trend indicator that is continuing to show an upward movement with that mathematical collaborative, the algorithm that's connected to the trend. So that the key is moving, saying the key opportunity came in around the third week, 3 weeks ago, then the bell came in, and now we're in the week where it says the one. That means it's continuing to move upward. The trend strength has been moving up for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks in a row. The signal line, you can notice that the Ethereum signal line is not as tight as the Bitcoin signal line was that we just saw. So therefore, the momentum of the upward is stronger than the Bitcoin momentum upward. And then the volatility index, unlike Bitcoin, it is outside of the red zone. So if you look to the right-hand side of the bottom volatility index indicator, you'll see it's 24.10. So it's just now out of the oversold zone, and it's in the black zone. And the wonderful part about Ethereum is we still have a long way to go to get to the green zone, which is the overbought zone. So if you're in the acquisition mode, these are places and signals that you really want to see. And we'll deep dive into some live charts because I want to go deeper into the average true range and the early reversal charts and talk about the Keltner bands there. So currently in the crypto mastery basket, we have Bitcoin, Ethereum, Polygon, Cardano, Chainlink, Litecoin, Cosmos, Algorand, Harmony, Phantom, and Solana. And most of these coins can be found on Coinbase. So the hot movers in the basket, this is not taking into consideration only those coins I just mentioned. So this is taking into consideration all the coins on Coinbase specifically. So currently, right now, we have trending up on the radar for one day and one week is Yasmi, Phil, API 13. And then in the combo zone, which means that these particular assets are either up for the week and down for the day, or down for the day and up for the week. So it's just those 2 week and one day are not unaligned, but there is a green space in there. So Doge, OGN, Gala, SHIB, Ethereum, Bitcoin, Tezos, Cardano, Aave, Litecoin, Atom, TRV, Plu, and DOT. Those are all they're moving up currently. So on a shorter time frame right now, but collectively on the day and the week, they're still in combo. So when you create a watch list on TradingView, you can organize your watch list by percentage change. And that's what this watch list was organized by. I did subcategorize these by if they were up for the day and the week, and if there were a combo day up and week down. But this one, beyond the subcategorization, I did click on that CHG percentage. And when you click on that, it's a hyperlink, it'll reorganize your watch list. So then you can also change it by the amount of change in price, the last price, the symbol name, and you can also add the subsections, which I've done on this, to your watch list to better organize what is ready to buy versus what is ready and ripe to sell. So this could be a what is ready to sell if you wanted to see what's up momentarily. So if you have any of these in your portfolio and you say, wow, they went up, like the one that went up 10.53%, you may say, oh, I've got enough profit, I can sell and still, come out ahead of the game. So the coins on the top are up for the day, but I always look for the coins on the floor that are ready for the next buy. So there is another subsection we'll show you on the live charts in a second, all the ones in the red zone. And those are always great to watch because those are hitting, they're most likely going towards the floor. We also have a crypto screener since we use TradingView to look at the charts. And so this is the TradingView screener with all of the green zones, so the ticker symbol with green. And so right now you could go on TradingView on your crypto screener and click technical rating, and it'll tell you what TradingView is saying is a strong buy or buy. So currently what you're seeing is what TradingView is suggesting. Now I don't really go by this when I'm purchasing or selling something. It's just a guideline. It's a good place to search for coins. And then you can sort by exchange name, and then you can organize your watch list. And so these slides are going to be more in depth in the members area of cryptomastery.online. Then you have the indicators that we have is volatility index, oversold conditions, the early reversal indicator, the dynamic average true range, the trend indicator, the trend strength indicator, the radar screener, and the signal line. And then in the members area, you'll be able to go through these charts and these tutorials, and you'll learn how that you could actually customize the time frame of the radar. So if you're an intraday trader, if you say, oh, I've got 15 minutes, I want to see what I can get in and out in 15 minutes, then you may want to go for some shorter time frames on your chart. So they are customizable. And then you have the trend indicator and the volatility index, signal line, trend strength. So let's jump into the charts, and I just want to give you a quick heads up. Again, if you guys need to subscribe to get these indicators, you go to cryptomastery.online. So now it's the fun part. We're going to do question and answer with Joe, and we're going to look at some live charts. So this is when you guys can get into your questions box and ask us anything. So Joe, Do you want to jump in and look at the watch list? Or you want to go over some Bitcoin?
Hi,
What do you
Susie.
do?
Hi, everyone.
Hey, guy.
Oh, well, first I'd like to start off, on a trade that I found in here, which I think is a good trade setup here, which is YFI USD. And you can make that on a daily. Okay, YFI, is that the same one? It looks like there's two eyes I have. Is there one in there with two eyes?
Why if I'll try a look.
Know, they have so many new coins that they put on this coin base.
Yeah,
Yeah,
you're
that one.
right. Oh, well, now, this is really good that this happened because when I was new in crypto, there was two king. This one coin I remember buying king or kings, and I ended up buying the wrong one. So that's important, guys. So you may want to go to CoinMarketCap.com and go by the actual name and not the acronym. So I'm gonna move my line, but this is beautiful, Joe. You want to tell them why? This is great.
Well, first is the this is looks good here because we just got the ERI today, which is the early reversal indicator, and in addition to that, we just got the first green on the TSI. So I thought this would be a great starting point for day because this is the ideal setup. Now, before we go too far into this, Susie, for anyone new that's following along, I want to show you how I found this because you got Coinbase and there's over 100 coins that they have in this place. So how is it that I was able to find this coin? Which right now I found like three that are good that I want to go over, but this one in particular, the way I found this is right there to the crypto screener. Now, first thing you do with this crypto screener is remove, well, first you set to the exchange that you have your broker. So in this case point, we're going to set it for Coinbase. Once we set for the exchange, we want to remove the other columns which create a lot of noise. So, Susie, if you could remove all the columns except for the technical rating and the exchange.
Okay.
Now, this crypto screener inside TradingView, it shows generic information in this screener. So this information by itself is useless, but that information used with the Crypto Mastery chart overlays is incredible because what it does is it helps steer you in the right direction of money flow because what this is doing is tracking money flow. So if you double click the technical rating, right, Susie, it'll show a sorting in there, first starting off with the strong buy. And you have to scroll up to the
So
top.
I'll just make it big. So there's no strong buy, but there's just the buys.
Okay, let's make sure.
Here's the YFII USD right here that you have found.
Okay, so I don't know why your strong buy isn't coming up. Is that set up on the daily?
Yeah, did you want it
Can you?
daily or a weekly?
Well, I just want you to scroll up. Is that as high as you can scroll?
Yes. And YFI is right here.
Okay. Why is it coming in?
Can we try a weekly? Or
No, it's just.
I'll just re so guys, sometimes you just want to refresh a little bit. So oh wow, I refreshed and it took everything away. Okay. Let me just do this again. And then we'll go back to filters and you click exchange Coinbase.
Yeah, maybe that's another setting. So, but that's okay. I'll fool around with it and try to see, just in case. I think that's another setting. But this is how I actually found this coin, is that I go in here with the screener, and then I sort it by the technical rating, and then I start going through the different coins, and I look to how to see what potential setups. Like, am I looking for a setup which is late? So, like Susie, for example, if you scroll up to the top, look, there's another one right there, good, which is the VEC BTC, just gave ERI. Yeah. So if I'm looking at something like this, if you can make the chart a little bit tighter, Susie. We're already like on a number three in a numeric count. So to me, this would be something that I'm late for. So I wouldn't see that as much as a potential present opportunity as the other coin, because we're already, it looks like this train has already left the station.
Went up 116%, guys, in 17 days from July 29th to August 15th.
Now,
That's great.
conversely, if you take a look at the coin below that, that just gave its ERI today. But in this case point, we don't have the TSI.
So all stars are not aligned on this one.
So let's go back to the other coin where we started with, which was YSFI. And let's talk about what we need to happen here as this trade progresses. Right. Now, if you can make that like just minimize the screener. There you go. So what we're looking for, what has happened? Okay, we have yes to the ERI, and we have yes on the TSI, so that's great. Now, the volatility index may not go all the way down there to the 20. See, on different time frames, it depends how the market moves, so you can't really depend on that one all the time. But what you can depend on is the two confirmations that we have, and then now what we're waiting for an additional, which is the signal line and the trend indicator. And those are two chart overlays where you can set your alerts for today. And Susie, when you set your alert, you put the name inside of there. And
Meaning,
for anybody new that's following along, if you have any questions, please put them across so that we know. On
yeah,
how to
guys,
set
and
alerts.
we have another 30 minutes. So, if you guys have any coins that you want us to specifically look at, something that you've actually got in your portfolio, then if you want an analysis of that, let us know and we'll pull it up. So, this is great.
Now,
So,
go ahead.
no, go ahead. Keep going.
Well, I was just going to say is that this one here is going to be interesting how over the next week this develops. What we're looking for, right, is that if you go to another coin, COVAL, this is like incredible. But I want to show this because this was a ERI setup again. And this is when the ERI and the TSI both said yes. Well, we got the ERI first, and then now 3 days later, we got the TSI, and then look at that move today. And this time it broke the ATR.
That's beautiful. So from the moment the ERI came, so I can get this exactly, went up 49% in 5 days. So the bottom, guys, you can see from August 11th to August 16th. And these are some coins that are within the last year new to Coinbase. So
yeah.
What I'm going to do is my Coinbase. So I'm going to go here and say Koval and Coinbase. See, that was just added. So you know what's really good, guys, to do to your watch list is, let me go back. So to add things to my watch list, instead of doing all sources, I'm going to click and just say just Coinbase. So you type in Coinbase here and see, you can see like, okay, this was the one. Oh, actually I have Koval in there. So I'm going to take Koval away, and anywhere I have an X, that means it's already added to my watch list. Now I don't have Euro because I'm not in Europe. I deal with USD, but if I was in Europe, then I would have a Euro. So I'm just going to go through here and say, wow, what is new? Chills has been on there for a while. Spell is new. OP is new. Anchor is not new. USDT and USD. I'm not going to add that because those are stable coins. And I'm not going to add that because that's British pound and British pound. So I'm looking for all the plus signs. So you can do this consistently to see if there's any Coinbase coins that they've added that you haven't added. So let me just make sure. I can add this, and that's Tether. Okay, so I think we've got it all. So then you could go back, and what I did prior to the webinar is I went on all of my coins, and then I clicked on them and looked at the radar to see what was completely up for the day, what was congruently up for the day and the week. So if both of these zones were green, I color coded it green. So what I'm going to do is go down to those new ones that I added. They typically pop up in the bottom. Okay, so Koval is up for both the day and the week. So then I'm going to code that green, and then I have these subcategorized. So here's my green section, and I'm going to look right here for the coin that is not, there we go, OPU is the new one that we just added, and this is up for the day but down for the week. So I'm going to make that orange, and then I'm going to pull this up to my combo zone and anchor. Looks like that one was actually anchors up for the day and the week. When I click through all of these coins, I give it a few seconds for the radar to actually update. So since Anchor is both up for the day and the week, that gets a green coding, and we'll just keep pulling this up to the green zone. I do want to let you guys know there's a lot of combo coins right now, more than all green or all red. And then Shiba just added, so let's see what that one is. So that's a combo down for the week, the day, but up for the week. All right. So does everybody have a watch list and know how to create one? Because I want to make sure that we're all collectively understanding how to use TradingView too. So please let me know if you guys have a watch list, and if you have some coins on them, let us know what coins you have on that watch list. So Joe, is there anything else that you want to go through really quick with them?
Yeah, sure. I mean, see, as we're talking, you know, I encourage everyone to, go through the screener with your brokerage. If there's any coins that you have a question on, I found another one. This is on another exchange, but I know that we have some guys that are on KeyCoin. So if you go to LSK ETH, and yeah, you have to change the exchange.
Yeah, that's right. So you go to all sources.
There you go. This is another one, which could be of interest for anyone that's on the KeyCoin exchange. Another ERI with the TSI. But in this case point, the volatility index is saying yes. So each time is a little bit different because it depends on how the market moves, how the market trades. The best thing that we can do is qualify and set levels. Like in this case point, what's really important to me on this example is the Kelcher band, Susie. You know,
yeah.
That gives you the final breakout level. So when you see it like really getting sideways like this, that's what you're looking for, that middle band. You know, and I look for it to close above that middle band. That means like if it breaks above it, then I'm looking for like at 5, I believe it's 5 Eastern time when the market, that daily closes and reprints its new bar. So if that happens in the morning, it's great, but I really need it to close above that because there's different case points. Like if you look at the last time, Susie, in August, look how that thing popped up. And then it went right back below that middle band.
From here to about 58% in 14 days. But that's if you're trailing it from this place.
Well, if you look at Susie, right, to the right, just look at the middle band. So we want to move it to August 1st or August 2nd. It's one bar that we're looking at.
You're talking about
right there. Yeah, that big bar. And if you look at the percentage right from that middle, right there, that middle moving average, the middle Kelcher band up, what percentage is that? That
from
day.
Here,
that all happened in one day up.
To like just the you want to
no,
go
no,
there?
Keep going up because that's a bar.
Oh, you
keep
want
going
this
up.
One. Okay. So on this particular day, say it went from that area to, got it. I don't like how that. All right, so about right there. So
yeah,
66%.
Yeah, and that's one day when it broke that band, and then you look at what happened the next day. It gave it all back, and then it went right back below that middle band again. And that's why when it breaks that level, you really need to take profits because there's been more than one time that I gave back a lot of money. I mean, you know, to the point where, you know, you don't even want to wake up in the morning. You just want to hug a pillow.
It went down 41% in 15 days.
Yeah.
From that time, from that like, very fast up and down.
Big move. Big move. Now, as I was going through here, so right now, this is one that you want to watch on the watch list and see if it's starting to move up higher.
So do you want to, can we just show them, I'm going to show them you guys really quick how to change your time frames. So if you're going to do more intraday trading, and this is 10 minutes, 30 minutes, 4 hours in one day. So if you're watching something and you're wanting to know like the best time to get in and you want to see kind of what's happening and you're trading intraday, then you could change your radar to know where is the market trending at these different time frames. When you're getting in, Joe, are you usually looking at 15 minutes? Or I like to look at the earlier time frames when I'm getting in.
You can use the radar in multiple ways. It's preferably on the longer time frames because we're trading and positioning for the overall trend. So if you get on a shorter term chart, it's going to show you a shorter cycle. So if you're a short term trader and you're looking to be in and out of the market in 24 hours, then it makes sense to go to a lower time frame. But for what we're doing, on the swing trading, a lot of the majority of our decisions are in the daily and weekly. So we may have to wait a little bit, but when we make a decision, there's a good chance that we'll get the follow through from the trend. So that really goes on to what type of trader do you want to be? Do you want to be a long-term trader or do you want to be a short-term trader? And with these tools, you can be both. But if you want the big profits, you're going to have to be in it to win it. But Susie, I don't know if you can change that chart over to the Bitcoin on the daily, because we got a ERI down, and if anyone is long in there, you want to look to maybe scale out, and take profits.
Yeah. So if you're following this, so we didn't really explain the Keltner bands. So just in case somebody's new here, should we explain the Keltner bands for them?
Oh yeah, sure. Go ahead.
So guys, that these bands are averages to get, I would say, a general expectation of where the candlesticks are going to hit, or when they go beyond this boundary, don't have amazing expectations, or just know the risk factor you're working with when it goes above the top Keltner band. And that's pretty much what, and then, well, beyond that it goes beyond that top band, that's usually the highest of the last averages. When it goes beyond there, then you need to think about taking profit, because there's a good chance it's going to go down. And then when you have, I call this the Houdini, it's like the magic indicator saying, hey, it's going to go down, and then it does, then that's when you've got to start thinking, okay, how far will it go down? Now, if you're in Europe, you could short the market and you could make some good money doing that. It's a zero sum loss. Somebody's making money all the way up and someone's making money all the way down. And the exchanges are always making money. But the next expectation, if this downward momentum continues, would be to this middle Keltner band. So let me just get that to where it is, like around that orange line. And then if it continues to move down, then if it passes this point and the downward momentum continues, then it's going to most likely hit the middle band. And these are constantly changing because it's an average. So as the day progresses, those lines will move. And that's what's beautiful about this indicator, is it moves instantaneously, meaning like that the actual lines do. But it's really good for correct expectations. But Joe, I want to take another consideration. Oh, wait, one other thing about this indicator that I find so fabulous is, do you see how these candlesticks are green? It's reflecting down here. Now, remember, we're on a 1 day chart, so this is going to look completely different if you're on a 1 week chart. But on the daily, this is for short term traders, it's right here on the volatility index. Remember earlier today, guys, I said if it's in the upper zone from 80 to 100, so here's 80 right here, and here's 100, so it's within the overbought zone, which is an indicator of taking profit. So I'll put a little dollar sign there, and it's not financial advice, guys, it's just to understand these tools. I'll just put the Bitcoin thing here because I can't find the dollar sign, but this is like the money zone, the profit zone. So if you have something, if you own an asset and it's in this zone within the trading time frame that you choose to trade in, then this is advantageous to say, hey, this is an indicator of a ceiling, a momentarily ceiling. And if you don't take profit when it's in this area, then you may need to have a lot of stamina to withstand the journey of it going back down, hitting a floor, and going back up. So if we put these on the charts, if you want to say what's the correct expectations I should have, if I'm not taking profit. So the last time we had a peak up in this area was March 29, 2022. So then I'm going to take this vertical line. I like this vertical line on TradingView because it goes through all the indicators, meaning like it will, the line goes everywhere. So the last time we were up this high on the volatility index was March 29, 2022. And now we're there, close to there on August 14, 2022. So how many months is that? We have April, May, June, July, August. We're not fully with August, but around 5 months. So the personal question you have to ask yourself for your own risk assessment, but mostly your stamina, is how are you going to feel, and can you financially withstand the test of 5 months of time to wait for something to maybe bounce back? And how are you going to be emotionally? I know this sounds silly, but if it drops, and are you going to be able to wait for it to go back up again? That's a personal question, and only you are going to know the answer. But this volatility index is such a substantial part of successful trading, in my opinion. Now, the way that you could use both of these indicators together is without having to really look at the volatility index, is the color of the candlesticks on the early reversal reflects what zone it's in the volatility index. So that's the beautiful part about these two. They somewhat simultaneously work together. So I'm going to click on the early reversal and open it. When you see red, that's a beautiful thing. That means it's on the floor of the volatility index. And when you see red below the bottom Keltner band, that's like a super sale. So that's when you know, wow, this is like a great opportunity. So this is a right here on a candlestick, the little line, that's called a wick, which means that we're on a 1 day chart. So it means within that 1 day when the price hit this low, it didn't happen long enough to withstand the candlestick to be thick and red. The wick means it was a, it did happen, and it's reflecting the movement down that low, but it didn't happen and sustain a long time frame for it to establish a thick candle. But it did still happen. So if you had at this day had a buy order in saying that you wanted to buy Bitcoin at this low price, it may have just hit it really quick and went back up. And therefore, let's see when it went back up. Let's just say you held it until maybe this mark. I can't get it. Let's say there. Then it would have gone up 26% in 20 days. And you're still, you're buying super low, that it doesn't have to go pretty high. But then it like literally, notice this upper Keltner band, it hit the top Keltner band, and then that was the ceiling, and it went back down. And then the next resistance was the middle band. And then it didn't go all the way back down to the floor, and it went back up. Notice these candlesticks are black. So we didn't talk about the black zone. This right here, see on the volatility index, it's black. That's the black zone, which we call it let the cake bake. It means it's just not the floor and it's not the ceiling. It's the middle zone. And then it went back down to the floor and now the black zone. And then here is the green, the overbought. So does this make sense to you guys? We have no questions in the questions box. So I hope you guys are, can somebody let me know, hey, you're out there and that you're able to gather this, and you have any questions about this. And Joe, is there anything you want to add to that? Because you've been trading for what, 25 years now, and successfully hitting home runs constantly. So is there any other advice you want to give our listeners today?
Well, what we want to do is if you have any positions here on the Bitcoin, you want to downsize, be aware that you have an ERI, and really we just want to go to another market. So let's change in here and go to the MANA ETH. This is something that we were looking at last week, the last couple of weeks, but today is a little bit something different going on. Now, usually if the Ethereum goes down, this goes up. Now, we haven't had an ERI yet, but it looks like today we got our first green dot on the TSI. And you can see it didn't really come back off that much. And that's why when you put trades on, you really want to scale into positions so you have staying power. Because, you know, it's not so much about being right all in one day. That's not how it's really done. It's really done scaling into your positioning and being able to survive another day. So, you know, in this case point, you could have scaled into your positions and you could have still been holding in that ship. And now this looks like we're about to get another wave at some point. Volatility index is way below the 20. And then today we just got the TSI. I mean, the only thing that would make this lovely if we just got a ERI print. So I'd have to keep a look on this the next day or two because that may be next in play.
Yeah, good find there. And what's beautiful about this, you can see in the 2 day, the 1 week and 1 month, those were all going down. So you're getting it at rock bottom pricing as far as the volatility goes at a 5.9 volatility. And the last time Mana Ethereum being purchased, Ethereum purchasing Mana got that low was May 11, 2022. So it goes up and it went up and stayed up since July 14th to July, wait, that's June, June 14th to July 1st. So this is a long time of moving upward. We have our question today. So Julie says, if we get into YF11, I think it's year in financial, over the next few days, but then BTC crashes, should we get out?
Well, if you change the chart back to the back to chart over, what you always want to look at is levels. So in this case point, our level would be in there like the previous lows that we had. So you see them lows, Susie, if you can put a horizontal line right there at the ATR.
And right here, the bottom one?
Yeah.
All right, hold
on. It should not break that ATR. So that would be considered like a level. And generally what I've seen is that sometimes when, and you're right, if the BTC crashes, generally the BTC may take everything with it. But there is in different case points where that may not happen all at the same time. So it's possible for BTC to go down and then also for this coin to go up and, you know, without BTC.
I want to just comment on that really quick because what I noticed earlier, guys, I showed you in the beginning slides is this dominance of Bitcoin is 30.94. If you go in our Facebook group and you look at the screenshot I put in there every week of the past week, you'll notice the Bitcoin dominance was 40%. So what that means is not that money is being taken out of the entire crypto market. It's just that the dominance of Bitcoin is being reduced, and that hasn't reduced that much in a while. So I guess what I'm saying is, Joe, even if the price goes down in Bitcoin, it just means that they're just not interested in Bitcoin. But collectively, I would say take into consideration the dominance level versus the overall money in the crypto market. So what I do is an overall analysis of I always like to know how much money is in the crypto market, to know my expectations. And if we're over 1 trillion, that I have a different set of expectations than when we're at 900 billion. And then also I always like to look at the Bitcoin dominance level because there's multiple key financial factors coming into play. So even though we think that the market's always based on Bitcoin. Just look at those other factors that are impacting that price, and maybe something else is taking more dominance. And you're going to see, I think, aggressive, almost a competition between Bitcoin and Ethereum. So check out, and like if you go back to Coin360 or the any kind of heat map, look at the size of the box and see what's happening. And also always take into consideration the USDC and the Tether, the stable coins, and the size of those boxes, because sometimes it's the money is just moving, but it's staying in the system. Joe, does that make sense to you?
Well, yes, like on this, in this case point, if you notice the middle Kelder band right now, the market is fighting. So I would say the first step when it comes to this coin is to look to see where the closing bar is at the end of the day, right? We need to get a close above that middle Kelder band, and then from that point we'd be looking for it to move to the upper Kelder band. So if you put the other chart overlays on, right? So if we can get a second dot on this TSI, it would be great. If we can get the signal line to cross, that would be lovely. If you take a look on the trend, right? The trend right now, there's no color on the bars. Everything is red. So you definitely want to have your alert set for the bell alert. This hasn't happened yet. So there's at least two opportunities that you have in here, in between the signal line and the trend indicator, which will also give you an additional confirmation to this market.
Which means
So.
that, if you whatever you have to invest, there's always a good procedure or best practices to not put it all in at once. So we've talked before about just slowly getting in a little bit on each indicator. So, Julie, do you have any other questions for us about this one? Because at this point, the only thing that is going good is the early reversal indicator. And but Joe, also the other thing is the average, right, where the average true range is still in the green zone too. So that's good. So there's actually two check marks on this one. Both of these are in alignment. But then the only other ones, the volatility index is not on the super floor, and then the signal line hasn't crossed yet. So I personally would say you're getting in early, and you're making a move off of two, three indicators in a good place. The volatility index is not in my favorite zone, which would have been down here. But it's very rare for everything to be down on that low volatility index. So Joe, on a scale of 1 to 10, where would you say you would put this as your letting the market come to you as like one of the best one opportunities right now for today?
Okay, well, two things. One, I just found another coin. Two, when it comes to this, let's just say on a scale from 1 to 10, right now this is like a 7, right? I mean, we don't have the volatility index, but we do have the TSI, which is oversold, and we do have the ERI, and as we get the closing bar on this, and if we get a cross on that signal line, well then the setup would be like an 8, and when we get the final trend indicator to kick in and we get the bell alert, well then that's your last mathematical confirmation. So you have two more indicators that could come in and trigger.
So, do you is it okay with you, Joe, if I just show them how to do a paper trade on this so they know how they can just test it? And everybody here, have you guys ever done a paper trade? Because it's the best way to practice.
Well, I mean, we're running out of time. Maybe we get into that
Okay.
next week. All right,
Okay,
but
yeah,
I just wanted
you're
to
at the
show one
clock.
more thing here, one more
Yes.
trade. If you go to OGN BTC.
Oh, that's
Right.
great.
This is another one where it had the ERI, and then today it just started to go up. So like like when we're doing these classes and presentations, I'm not just sitting over here. I'm working always behind the scenes, looking to try to show you the best examples to learn from for the time that you spend with me, for the time that I'm doing this, so that you could learn and be able to try to be able to develop, and evolve to become your own type of trader. And this is one of the situ one case point where we have the volatility index is oversold. We have the first green dot on the TSI. Now we've been on a bell alert for a whole month, but it's just not until recently where we got the green dot today on the TSI, it started to go up. And notice this, the pair symbol. It's BTC, OGN BTC. So we may see the Bitcoin go down and we may see the pair go up. So this is going to be something, to watch over the next week. Because this just started to break the middle Kelder band today, Susie.
And this makes sense. Remember, I showed you guys that Bitcoin is losing its dominance is being reduced because people are going into Bitcoin, holding Bitcoin, and now they're using Bitcoin to buy altcoins. So they're not going back into a Tether or a stable coin before they go into an altcoin. They're literally trading Bitcoin for another coin. Which could be making sense because the money's staying in the market, and you can tell that the money's staying in the market when you look at the total market cap. That's why it's like the first thing I look at when I start doing my trading every day is I look at the total overall market cap of all of crypto. So it's just inside the market trading. Good find, Joe. This one looks great. And what I do love about this one is the Keltner band. I mean, well, would let it drop a little bit below the average. So on a one day, if you're going to manage your trades by the one day, it is kind of at the top of the Keltner band. And the one thing we're waiting on is that we are waiting on the average true range to switch to the enter. So that's another thing you want to look at up here. You want to the green here. But it's still early entry. They're profitable.
Well, the ATR is always last. It lags, right? Because it's going to adjust to the average true range. So if the market has been going sideways the last since July, it's just been consolidating, consolidating, consolidating. So the day that it breaks that ATR, it just may just pop. So you don't. If you want to position yourself before the ATR, because the day that it breaks the ATR, the market may just move so far, too fast, and you'll miss it. It's happened to me before. I mean, even with all the experience I have, I miss trades because I don't take profits fast enough when it spikes up. That happens to me. Or in this case point here, I always scale into my trades because if I wait for the trade to be perfect, I might be sleeping and then the market breaks and then I miss that too. So it's one thing of having the tools, and then it's another of applying them strategically and scaling into your positions so that you win.
Yeah, and lastly, I'm gonna just zone in on this last time the ATR came in, and I'll delete that line, but watch this. So here's where the one came in with the trend, and then when the ATR finally hit 2 days, it went up 80%. So I hear what you're saying, Joe, and this is showing what you're saying, is that the trend picked it up. The TSI hadn't even switched yet, but the trend saw it coming, and then 80%. But take note, this is a one day chart. So this is one of those things where when you see it go up 80%, that's take profit time. You guys can be on it. And it had just moved out of the volatility index right here and pulled over into the oversold very fast. So these moves happen fast. I mean, that's a lot of movement in 2 days. That's where magic is made. So thanks for that explanation. I hope that helps you guys understand the significance of the switch from the average true range of downward to upward. All right. Well, it was joy being with you guys today. Thanks for the question, Julie. And we look forward to you guys telling us about your trades of this week. And if anybody wants to do paper trading, let us know. And we'd love to teach you that next week if you need help with that. So that if you're still a little timid to actually jump into the market, that you can start winning on your paper trading. Do you want to say anything before we go, Joe?
Good luck trading, and you have any questions or any coins that you're watching, when you're with us, the time you spend, try to make as valuable as possible and ask the questions or just type it across so that we can better help you. And good luck trading.
Good luck, guys. See you next week.